We got the McDonald's guy in the studio here today. You saw last week when I said I've been eating McCless for months. I exaggerate. I mean, this guy's my hero. Every day for a month, nothing but McDonald's.
Yeah.
He looks great, too.
And he's feeling good.
Looks good. Yeah, feels good.
He looks good.
Yeah. And he brought some food with him.
He even brought some proof.
He's got a full
array
of what you can do if you're trying to make some healthy choices when you go there.
Hats off to this guy. You know?
Yes, no fries that look like Abe Lincoln, though.
Really?
From what I can see.
Did he check everyone? See, I don't check everyone.
Well, now I check for these things.
Bring a QP with C.
Stuff them all in.
A QP with C.
Nobody says that.
Quite sure.
Don't talk
647.
I'm trying to make it catch
degrees.
On. That's a quarter pounder with cheese.
Great. Minus 14. Minus 10 driving home today. Fast food and a healthy lifestyle don't typically seem to go hand in hand, but over the next one, local man hopes to prove that perception wrong. Les Sayer joins us now with his plans for a rather unusual experiment. Good morning, Les. Nice
to
meet you. Thanks for all the food you brought with you.
Yeah, tuck in.
So where'd you get this idea of eating at McDonald's from? Is it from that movie?
It was inspired by Morgan Spurlock's Super Size Me movie. So where the host, Morgan Spurlock, goes off on a 30-day all-McDonald's diet. So that's really the inspiration behind this.
So is that what you're doing? You're going 30 days as well?
Yeah, it's not the same as, in fact, it's not. It's just inspired by his experiment. So otherwise, other than the 30-day McDonald's diet, everything else is kind of different.
So what's going to be different compared to what he did?
Well, he was trying to mimic the average American, you know, the over-consuming American, and he put on weight and got sick and so forth. And I think if I was just to reproduce that, I'd end up suffering the same results. What I'm trying to do is illustrate that you can eat the same food, you can eat a variety of the same type of food anyways, and together with some nutritional supplements and exercise activity, you can lose weight and be healthy.
So what you're saying is the way he did it, he gained the 25 pounds, the way you did it, hopefully you're not going to.
Yeah, I think there was a message that, there's several messages that he left. One of them was a big anti-corporate message thing, but which I'm not really interested in getting into. But but the other message distinctly is that not only is McDonald's food not good, but it's also bad for you. And I think that's a little bit unfair because there is food here that is... you know, if taken in with moderation and coupled with a healthy lifestyle, should be good for you.
Right. So how are you tracking your progress?
Well, I have a physician who performed a medical week before last, and they had blood work done, as well as a weigh-in. And I'll probably have another weigh-in in a couple of weeks' time. And then at the end of this exercise, I'll have another set of blood work done and see how they compare, as well as the weigh-in, of course.
So in your travels, what has the response been from those who you've been talking to, the general public, I guess?
Well, people who I meet in the street, they seem to be okay with it. My colleagues and students think it's an interesting thing. But I've been getting a lot of emails that range from, way to go, to you call yourself a science teacher, to I hope you get sick. So quite a variety.
Well, that's it. You are a teacher, and you're trying to set an example for these kids who are coming to gain knowledge from you on a daily basis. Are you setting a good example by eating, quote, junk food on a daily basis?
Well, the example I'm trying to set is be informed. You know, make this is the whole thing behind this exercise, actually, was know how to make an informed decision. Take opinions from one side, take opinions from another side, you know, do a little bit of research. And then when you've got all your information, then... make an informed decision. I mean, this is really what it's about. And
sure.
I'm finding them getting emails from people who, you know, even academics, you know, they're just going off a 60 second news report and trying to make an opinion from that. And that's what I'm trying to go against.
So what response are you getting from McDonald's? Are they helping you out here?
No, they're not. And it's probably a good thing they're not, actually, because it maintains my objectivity.
Right,
so,
I see.
But no, I think they're taking a wait and see kind of an approach right now.
So. Are we going to be able to track your progress? Is there a website we can go to or something? Or?
Yep. My website is www.mcles.com, M-C-L-E-S.com. So, I mean, I have daily updates to let you know what I'm eating. And I think that's probably one of the good things about this exercise. The people can see that it's, you know, in real time almost, that I'm eating, you know, the food that you don't have to buy from a special place, you know, and food you don't have to weigh out in special portions or anything. And I'm putting down there my details of my exercise regimen, and you can be tracking it and seeing what is actually happening.
Well, excellent, Les. Nice meeting you, and good luck. Best of luck.
Thank you.
Les will be following his McDonald's only diet until March 2nd, and as he mentioned, you can follow his progress by logging on to mcles.com.
Global News Morning Edition with Shay Ganim, Andrea Engel, and Mike Sobel.
Good morning. It's 7 a.m.
Can I just mention something really quickly?
Please
We're talking
do.
To Les, the fellow who's going to be eating at McDonald's for the next 30
yes.
days. And one thing he neglected to mention was that February is Eating Disorder Awareness Month.
Okay.
And they've got a very special session at Ross Shep School coming up Wednesday night from 7 to 8:30, hosted by Eating Disorder Education Organization. Les will be there. They're going to be showing some clips from Super Size Me, and
okay.
should be a very interesting evening. So
seriously,
something
to
keep in mind.
Yeah, for sure.
Anyway, weather for